सिंपल पेंड्यूलम। अ सिंपल पेंड्यूलम इज बेसिकली एन ऑब्जेक्ट सच एज स्मॉल मेटालिक बॉल टाइड टू अ थ्रेड ऑफ 1 मीटर लेंथ एंड सस्पेंडेड फ्रीली फ्रॉम अ नॉन मूविंग स्टैंड। द मेटालिक बॉल इज कॉल्ड बॉब ऑफ द पेंड्यूलम। When the bob is taken to one side and released, it starts moving to and fro. During motion, there are 2 positions where the bob stops and change its direction. These positions are called extreme positions of the pendulum. Let's denote them by A and B. There is a moderate position between the 2 extreme positions. It is called the mean position of the pendulum. Let's denote it by O. When the bob is at rest, it is at its mean position, that is O. The motion of bob, that is the motion of simple pendulum, repeats itself after certain time. Such motion is said to be periodic or oscillatory motion. The bob completes 1 oscillation when it moves from mean position, goes to one of the extreme position, and then to the other extreme position and returns to the mean position again. The time taken by the bob to complete 1 oscillation is called the time period of the pendulum. We measure the time period by measuring the time required to complete an oscillation from the extreme position. It is difficult to measure the time period in one go. Here is a method to measure the time period of the pendulum. Mark the mean position of the bob on the floor. Switch off the fans. Take a clock to measure time, preferably a stopwatch. Keeping the string taut, bring the bob to one side. Now release the bob and at the same time start the stopwatch. Go on counting the oscillations. Stop the stopwatch as soon as the pendulum completes the 20th oscillation. Make a table and enter the time taken to complete 20 oscillations. Take few readings performing similar activity and note down all the readings. For each reading, calculate the time period of the pendulum by dividing time by number of oscillations, that is 20. Is the time period nearly same in all cases? Yes, you will find that the time period is same in all the cases. A simple pendulum repeats its motion after fixed time period. We can take it as reference to measure time. In fact, we can use any periodic motion to measure time. Clock that we use to measure time is also based on periodic motion of its hands. Here we complete this topic. Thanks for watching this video. For more videos, log on to learnfortougher.com and get your favorite course the way you want.